Good evening, and welcome to the third session of the second round of the Cleveland International Piano Competition. I'm Yaron Kohlberg, president of Piano Cleveland. We're proud to present 26 wonderful contestants in this competition, and they've recorded their first two rounds in 10 locations worldwide. As you will see today as well, some contestants will be wearing their masks and some will not. However, this does not by any way influence their chances of making the semifinal round. Tonight, you'll hear performances by ZIYU, Daria Parkhomenko, RAFAEL SKORKA, and BOWEN Lee. Today, we'll also have an intermission feature, and it will be presented by Donna Lee, professor of piano at Kent State University. Tonight's performance is generously supported by Intercontinental Cleveland. As in every session, you are welcome to communicate directly with your favorite contestant by saying hello on the broadcast page. You can also donate to the contestant fund, which will support the artists who do not make the semifinals in Cleveland, and this is extremely meaningful for these young artists. We hope you will consider it. Thank you very much for joining us, and we hope you will enjoy today.
Hello, I'm ZIYU. I'm from China, and I look forward to sharing with you my second round performance. I'm very happy to be part of the Cleveland International Piano Competition this year, and for me it means a great opportunity to share my music in this difficult time. In times of crisis, music could bring us energy and help us to face the difficulties and overcome this difficult time.
Thank you. Hello, my name is Daria Parkhomenko and I'm from Russia. I look forward to sharing my second round performance with you. First of all, it is a great honor for me to participate in such a prestigious competition. I know about this competition since I was a child, and I am very happy to be selected for the participation at Cleveland Piano Competition. I'm very excited to present myself and perform a program that I'm absolutely in love with. And of course, it would be very interesting to play for the American audience, which I know is very warm and open. Unfortunately, during the period of the pandemic, there are many negative moments. Many events, concerts have been cancelled, and it is not so easy for me as a pianist to show myself in this situation. Fortunately, music is always with us, and in this situation, it pushed me to new goals. I tried to devote a lot of time to myself and music, worked on a new program, read and walked. Enjoying nature, I was inspired for my new musical ideas and new projects, so it gives me a lot of motivation to work further.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Hello, I'm Donna Lee, and I thank you for tuning into this portion of the Cleveland International Piano Competition. Russian composers have greatly contributed to the piano literature, providing some of the most beloved gems and war horses to our vast repertory. These Russian greats include Tchaikovsky, Rachmaninoff, Prokofiev, Shostakovich, to name just a few. Their music is undeniably Russian, containing nationalist traits of folk elements, including their use of melodies and church bells, harmonies rich in texture, and virtuosity to convey great power and dramatic temperament. Coming up, we will hear two contestants play selections by Sergei Rachmaninoff, including four preludes from his two sets, Opus 23 and Opus 32. Rachmaninoff composed a total of 24 preludes, following Bach and Chopin in writing one in every key. The first set of 10 preludes, Opus 23, was written during a most joyful period in his personal life, with his marriage to Natalia Satin in 1903. And although the happy event may have been the impetus for the writing of this set, much of the music is made up of nostalgic sadness, particularly in the first prelude. The second set of 13 preludes was composed 8 years later. Opus 32, number 10 in B minor, was inspired by Arnold Bachlin's painting entitled The Homecoming. It is an ironic foreshadowing of Rachmaninoff's eventual exile from his homeland country that he loved so dearly. The emotional conflict is felt in this prelude, complete with wavering modes between major and minor, the heart-throbbing surge of the accompaniment triplet rhythms that overpower and come crashing down like clanging church bells that lead to a resolution that never arrives. This is much like yearning for a homecoming that would never come. For those of you who are quickly calculating that we are short one prelude, you're absolutely right. He wrote his first prelude in C-sharp minor in 1892, and this is perhaps one of his most popular pieces, and it belongs in his Opus 3 set. We will also hear a pair of Étude-tableaux from the composer's second set, Opus 39. Étude-tableaux translates to study pictures. And whereas these Études indeed focus on technical skills, the importance of the works lies in the tableau, the pictures that Rachmaninoff vividly crafted to create a most colorful story and aural painting. With specific impressions in mind, Rachmaninoff never clarified what each of these pictures were. Instead, he wanted the listener and performer to, quote, paint for themselves what it most suggests, end quote. Also found in each of these 9 etudes from this set is his lifelong fascination with the music of Dies Irae, Day of Wrath. These melodies come from the liturgy of the Requiem Mass, with the text describing the Day of Judgment when all souls must account to God for their sins. Rachmaninoff completed these Étude-tableaux in 1917, the year of the Russian Revolution. The 9th etude would be the last work he composed before fleeing his country with his wife and daughter and eventually settling in the United States. The clanging bells, the triumphant march, albeit devoid of joy, perfectly describes the political climate that must have surrounded him. Rachmaninoff has said, "Love, bitterness, grief, or religious feelings, all these make up the content of my music. These contents, rich in expression, have made him a most beloved composer for both performer and audience alike. I hope this will add to your positive viewing experience in the upcoming performances. Thank you."
Hi, my name is Rafael Skorka from Israel, and I look forward to sharing with you my second round performance. Participating at the Cleveland International Piano Competition at COVID-19 days for me is a way to keep myself goal-oriented and also in playing shape. Like many other musicians and artists and performers, during this pandemic, I found myself stepping away from the stage So being able to return now and share my music with others makes me feel humbled and privileged. Music is always a big part of my life, and especially in times of crisis, I find solace in music and it fills me with meaning. But using music as a form of communication is what I think makes it special and powerful. It's a universal language, and being on stage and playing can't be replaced. So I'm really excited about being a part of the Cleveland competition, and I really hope you can feel the passion I have for playing for others and expressing myself and my emotions through the music. So I hope you enjoy. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Bowen Lee and I'm from China. I look forward to sharing my second round performance with you. A few years ago, I held many recitals in different cities in China. The audience asked an interesting question. What did you think before going on stage? I thought for a while, and I answered, I want to tell you a story with music. This is a memorable music experience for me.
Thank you.